This video is going to cover an EDI transaction called a 270 eligibility request. This is an EDI data file. It is a request and response type of EDI transaction where the 270 is sent typically by a provider to request a eligibility of a procedure code or maybe a drug code or some other code like American Dental Code, for example. And then the health plan or payer would send back a 271 response to this transaction. And it would go, and then at that time they would go over the eligibility. I'm going to show you some key elements in the eligibility request and some live data examples. So with that in mind, let's take a look at the CAT claim adjudication system and we'll pull up one of these 270 requests. As we do a quick walkthrough on this transaction, you'll see standard enveloping with the ISA and GS segment. Notice that the transaction ID is actually 279, and so you want to take note of that to make sure that you're dealing with the right transaction. Some folks will key on this instead of, for example, the transaction name, for example, but you could actually use either one. In the ST01, the 270 means that this is an eligibility request. After that, there's the beginning segment, which is pretty much standard. In the first hierarchical level, there's an NM1 segment with a PR qualifier and NM101, and this will show you that this is a healthcare payer, and NM1 8 and 9 will show you the qualifier and the payer ID. The second hierarchical level will show you a 1P in NM101. That will show you that this is, in fact, the provider, and NM108 is going to equal XX, which stands for your MPI number for the provider, the national provider ID, and you'll have a 10-digit code, and then the demographics. In the third hierarchical level, you'll see that there's trace numbers and also NM1IL to show you the subscriber name and then the member ID. This is assigned by the payer. You'll see that NM108 equals MI and NM109 is the payer assigned member ID. And then at that point, you can see some possibly some demographic information like date of birth or gender. Note that in this transaction, you could have a diagnosis code. And if you do, it will be in the HI segment with a qualifier ABK. And then your ICD-10 code will follow. Now we're going to get down to really the most important segment, I think, in this transaction, and that is the EQ segment. If a health plan or payer is not going to support this to the extent that they could, they're required to go and at least use a 30 for a health benefit plan, and this is part of the CORE or CAQH requirements. So if you're not going to support all the details, and there are several types of eligibility requests that you could have, but if you're only going to support one, then you have to support the health benefit plan coverage. And again, that's the CORE requirements. If you're not sure about what I'm talking about with CORE videos, CORE responsibilities, that's probably something for another video. But basically what that means is that HIPAA came out and gave you all the rules for what you have to follow. And you have also WEDI and SNP levels. You know, there are 7 levels to go over. But the CORE rules come by and tell you the extent to which you're going to be required to implement any one of these HIPAA transactions. So for the 270, you're required at least to have a 30. Now, if that's all you're supporting, then you won't see an EQ02 segment. It will just say EQ30, for example, and have a tilde, for example. But if they are going to support it, EQ01 could equal 30, it could equal 55 for major medical, or 64 for acupuncture, 88 for pharmacy, 90 for mail or prescription drug, massage therapy would have a BE, mental health would have an MH. There are dozens of these codes. I've just included a few of them here to help you see some of the variety that you'll have. In the EQ02 element, it's actually a composite. If they're going to check on the eligibility of a procedure code, it will say HC for HCPCS code, but they could actually put another code in there, for example, N4 for NDC code, or it could say, for example, AD for American Dental Code, and then the code would follow. Note also that in these transactions, you could have, for example, 4 more modifiers. I'm just going to show you. So, you know, and I just put a Z in there for filler, for example, but you could have 4 additional modifiers on this, for example, that could be sent in eligibility request. So I think this probably will get you into the ballpark with a general understanding of how eligibility works. If you have any other requests or questions about this transactions, you can drop me a note. And I think probably some of the other videos, I might go over some maybe some of the other different scenarios that you might have. If you have a scenario that you'd like to go over, just drop me a note and we can cover it then. So thanks for watching my video, and I hope that this has helped out.